Welcome to Flat Out Elected. My name is Rand Campbell, and we are here in the jungles of the Dominican Republic. It is absolutely beautiful today, very tranquilo, very tranquil, very relaxing. However, today we are going to dig really, really deep into what is going on here in this world. You see, we are to have no gods before our God, our living God, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We are not to worship idols, but here we are in a world worshiping idols. Now, idol worship goes back a very long way, but idol worship has advanced as time has gone on. What we see today in this world with the idols, those of which whom this world applauds and idolizes, is beyond human imagination when you wake up and realize just exactly who it is that they're idolizing, who it is that they're worshiping. You see, they're not worshiping people. No, that's not who they're worshiping. These are demons within the flesh that have manifested into the flesh that are performing and entertaining, entertain, to sustain, detain, retain, contain, meant the mind, to enter and hold the mind. These are who people are applauding and worshiping. These are the idols. This is what they're doing. I told you that the mind is the devil's playground, and this is exactly where the demons operate. They operate in your mind. This is how they affect your heart. This is how they affect your inability to seek God in a spiritual and deep way. People are amazed and in awe of these idols, just absolutely captivated by them, captivated, held captive. Thank you, Lord. So we're going to look very, very deeply into these idols and how they perform and entertain those that have taken the door off their mind and allowed these demons to come in and exist and captivate them. We have no clue how deep this goes, but we are getting some pretty good knowledge as per the increased knowledge seen in Daniel 4. You know, this world is 100%, and I've said this before, it is for sure, come on now, it is for sure a satanic ritual, and people have no idea that they are worshiping demons. And as a result, worshiping the God of this world, Satan. Because I've said this before too, Satan could care less about money and power. That means nothing to him. He covets worship. He covets that your soul would be lost and captivated by the demons that possess your mind and have you idolizing and worshiping them. This is going to get deep. I hope you're ready for this. I told you, this is a satanic ritual that we live in. This is not what you think it is. You have been given an opportunity to be removed, to be separated. But not everybody takes that gift. Not everybody accepts the gift. As a matter of fact, most people love this world so much, they reject the gift because they're captivated and held in a prison of lies and deception. We're going to take a look at who these demons are, because you're going to be pretty surprised. I know most of you already know, but we're going to take a real, real hard look at the demons. We're going to search them out, and we're going to expose them in this video. You guys take some time, watch this video. I'll come back at the end to close out. But for sure, 100%, this video is going to wake up a lot of people. Some are going to wake up angry, and others are going to wake up relieved and in search of the only truth this world has ever known, and that truth is Jesus Christ. Watch this video.
Perhaps we need some outside universal threat. I occasionally think how quickly our differences worldwide would vanish if we were facing an alien threat from outside this world. And yet, I ask you, is not an alien force already among us?
Face changing, also called mask changing. In face changing, what look like masks instantly appear on the faces of the performers. Kwan is considered to be the best face changer in the world. For example, in one of his 3-minute performances, he changed his face 60 different times. It's quite obvious from looking at different performances by Kwan that he could change his face 500 different times in 3 minutes. Take a look at this guy. He doesn't even touch his face. Notice how every single time he changes his quote mask, it is placed perfectly on his face, covering his eyes and nose every single time. Kwan also said that the man who taught him this secretive practice was destined to teach him face changing. Kwan went on to say that he was taught face changing in only 3 days. Kwan and other face changers will even interact with the audience and change their face right in front of them. Kwan spoke about one of his shows in which 3 cameras were set up to record his performance. The cameramen were attempting to discover how he makes the rapid changes. 2 cameras were right in front of him, while 1 followed from behind. Nevertheless, they still couldn't find anything that gave them any insight into how he is able to change his face so quickly. If someone believes his process of changing the masks is natural, he would have to be storing them somewhere, right? But face changers like Kwan take off their hat after their performance, and you can see that there aren't any masks in the hat they wear. You can look at it. There isn't even 1 mask inside their hat. So where are they storing the masks? Notice how tight the outfit is below the neck. Obviously, the masks aren't being placed there either. What's really happening is that the masks are actually disappearing instantly. That's why, even to this day, no video camera in the world has ever picked up even one clue as to how their, quote, masks are changing. No one has been able to give a natural explanation for how these face changers are able to do what they do. The only explanation is a spiritual one. In these clips, also notice that various face changers use a hat with horns on it. He Hongqing is the fastest face changer in China. Notice the two horns on top of his hat. One skeptic is baffled by how he changes his face as quickly as he does. But the skeptic doesn't believe it's supernatural. He explained to the viewing audience that others have tried to slow the recording down to figure out how he does it. But he says that there is no point in doing that because the magician is just, quote, too good at what he does. One cameraman admitted that he adjusted his camera to capture how the changes were being made, but he couldn't pick up any clues as to how it's being done. The real explanation for how the instant changes are made is that they happen with the assistance of demons. World-famous face changer Quan said, quote, face changing is a very secretive art form. Quan will not only change his face over and over again during his performances, but he will also instantly change the color of his entire outfit. So where is he getting the new outfits that he's instantly changing into? There's no place for him to store the outfits or the masks. How is he able to switch and move the outfits and the masks perfectly in the blink of an eye? If people are looking for a natural explanation for these acts, they won't find one. There's simply no natural explanation for the instant transformation of his garments or masks, let alone both. In this clip, face changer He Hongqing makes an interesting statement about how the instantaneous changes are made.
Actually, what is amazing about face changing is its mystery. Through performance and movements, performers are in effect playing with magic. In fact, face changing is a kind of magic.
He essentially admits that face changing is supernatural when he says that face changing is, quote, playing with magic. We will now look at statements from other top magicians who admit that their magic comes from spirits. It needs to be pointed out that God has clearly revealed that to contact unknown spirits or to, quote, channel them is mortally sinful. It's activity he condemns. Those who do so open themselves up to demons and invite them to take possession of their souls.
No way!
David Copperfield is the most famous magician in history. Copperfield has openly admitted that spirits are solely responsible for some of his magic. Copperfield has also traveled the world collecting items which people say are haunted. He has spent millions collecting these magic items.
You see, I've been traveling around the world collecting artifacts, items that people say are haunted. They say if you concentrate hard enough, you can awaken the spirits inside these objects and cause the objects to move without explanation. I brought one of those objects with me tonight. It's that table over there, folks. Pick up the table and bring it down here. And everybody, get down on one knee. Just keep your fingertips lightly in contact with that table. Keep your eyes right here at the center. Right here at the center of the table. Don't press down. Exactly. We're going to try to concentrate and awaken the spirits inside this table and cause it to rise up into our fingertips. But it's important you follow my instructions exactly. I want you to concentrate right here and very slowly. Stand up in slow motion. Feel it rise. Feel that table rise. Slower, slower. Feel it rise. Then we'll rise. Yes. Listen carefully now. Lift up both hands.
Put them back. Catch it. Bring it up. Bring it up. Bring it up. Bring it up.
This table will do whatever we tell it to do. Table, come this way. Come on, table. Move this way. Come on. If you feel it move, move with it. Back this way. Come on, table. Move this way.
I have an incredible museum of magic that's dealing with all the artifacts of all the great magicians of the past. Their posters, their programs, their books, hundreds of thousands of magic books.
Welcome to my secret, top secret, the International Museum and Library of the Conjuring Arts, with items belonging to Keller, Houdini, Thurston, all the great masters of the past.
I just bought this big magic collection.
Mm-hmm.
That was about to get split up and kind of either split up and or sent out of the country. And one of the first things, one of the greatest things in the collection is this first magic book. And the reason it was written was because it's called The Discovery of Witchcraft. It was written in 1584.
Copperfield founded the International Museum and Library of the Conjuring Arts. The museum comprises approximately 80,000 items of magic history. It is reportedly the world's largest collection of magic memorabilia. Some appraisers have estimated Copperfield's magic collection alone to be worth $500 million. One of the items in the collection treasured by Copperfield is the remaining portion of a house of prostitution. During a storm that swept through the area, the house of prostitution was struck by lightning and all the prostitutes were killed.
The presence of ghosts and spirits have been documented for centuries. In 1931, the Barclay House mysteriously burned to the ground. All of its occupants perished in the fire, but some say they live on.
Do you believe in ghosts? If you don't, before the night's over, we might change your mind.
She says, "That's impossible."
Of course it's impossible. That's why we do it.
And you wouldn't believe it, but you can create a miracle with just about anything.
Earth, wind, fire, water. How can I manipulate those elements to create an apparent miracle?
We're gonna have to create miracles.
You know, I'm gonna create miracles in the audience.
And you see miracles literally inches away.
I don't even know what you
That's
did.
That's not even a trick, is it?
It's not a trick. What I do is not tricks. Some people perceive it to be supernatural.
So I don't want people to be tricked. I'm not showing them a trick. It's about magic.
David Blaine, quote, "Robert Houdin's theories of magic were what intrigued me the most. His notion that a magician is an actor who plays the part of someone with supernatural powers. Again, Jesus describes those who do these false signs and wonders as false Christs and false prophets. These magicians work wonders that some believe are similar to what Jesus did. They cannot do what Jesus did, but God allows the devil to use magicians to perform numerous signs that deceive people. They are false Christs performing false signs and wonders. They are attempting to either replace Christ or claim that they are like him while preaching a false gospel."
Who's the greatest magician, Dave, besides yourself?
David Blaine.
Jesus Christ.
In the next clip, Chris Angel is angry because he feels Magician Dynamo stole his signature pose, which Chris says he got from Jesus.
But he even like steals my like my tableau, my pose, you know. Now, I didn't invent that pose. That's depicted by Jesus Christ. But I was the guy to do that in magic, you know, and the way that I look and my image.
Chris says that he's the one who originally started using that pose in magic. When Jesus was crucified, his flesh was pierced with nails and he hung on a cross for 3 hours. It's interesting that on one occasion, Chris Angel had hooks inserted into his back and then attached to a helicopter so that he could fly around in the air in his, quote, signature pose. He did something similar on another occasion. He described it in his book saying, quote, "I hung for 3 hours." This is Chris Angel's Las Vegas dressing room for his show Believe. As you can see, Chris put up on his wall this blasphemous cross with his skullhead image on top of it. As you can see on ChrisAngel.com, Chris describes this image as the, quote, "Chris Angel skull logo." So he puts his logo on the cross and places it up on display on his wall. This is a blasphemy against Jesus Christ. This is a famous Greek magician who has levitated on a number of occasions. Notice how when he levitates, one foot goes over the other. Most believe that when Jesus was crucified, one nail went through both of his feet. David Blaine is also a false prophet and a false Christ. In this clip, notice that he puts his arms out like he is Christ being crucified. Blaine uses words to describe his, quote, miracles that have been used to describe real miracles of God. Quote, "For those who believe, no explanation is necessary. For those who do not, none will." Some of Jesus' most well-known miracles were walking on water, multiplying loaves and fishes, and changing water into wine. This is a magician named Yif. He is the most famous magician in China. He has appeared to change water into wine. He says that Jesus was a magician like him who lived 2,000 years ago and performed this miracle. Attempting to be like Jesus, Chris Angel walked on water when he walked on Lake Mead, which is located near Las Vegas, Nevada. Dynamo walked on the River Thames in front of thousands of people. This was the key moment in Dynamo's career as a false Christ and a false prophet. Dynamo described this event as, quote, "the moment I'd been building up to my whole life." The false Christ Dynamo also appeared to cause many fish to come out of an empty bucket during his trip to South Africa.
They've been looking for a new street magician, and that guy is me. I'm gonna let you know that right now. Jabrizi. And I've been thinking about changing my name to Jabrizis, turning water into wine, walking on water.
Okay, so if this video didn't give you a deeper understanding of just exactly what it is that is going on in this world in respects to entertainment and how captivated people are by these idols and by these false prophets, because that's exactly what they are. They are inspired by demons, period, dot, period. You can see it in their eyes. You can see it in what they do. They even speak about it. And by their very mocking of Jesus Christ, they verify just exactly what it is that they're doing. Now, you could say, no, there's no demon possession. This is incredible magic, an incredible illusion, an incredible sleight of hand. Ay. No, it's sleight of mind. They are literally demon possessed. Period, dot, period. These people have absolutely 100% given up their souls, given up their minds to demons, and these demons are what entertain you. So when you watch these magicians and you watch these what would appear to be unimaginable acts of magic and illusion, make no mistake about it, what you are witnessing is very spiritual, and it is very deep. And it is absolutely designed in that Jesus Christ would be mocked and that people would believe more in demons and have more of a admiration, an idolizing of demons, of which are directly associated to the God of this world, of which we know is the great deceiver. So all of this is pure deception. That's why magic is such an amazing tool for demons, because you know it's a deception. You've been led to believe that it's a deception, But what your mind thinks is that it's just good magic, that it's just a very good trick. And that's exactly what it is. It is something that is tricking you into applauding and worshiping Satan. That's exactly what it is. It is a trick to get you to worship the God of this world, because that's exactly what he covets, and that's exactly what he's after, and that's exactly, sadly enough, what he is getting in this world. So if you're a Christian and you choose to be as Christ was, or to choose to live in Christ, that Christ would be in you, these types of things should become obvious to you. You should watch these entertainers, these captivators, and you should be able to see exactly what it is that they're doing. If you can't, then channels like this will provide the information that you can look at, that you could hopefully have the scales removed from your eyes, and that you would see exactly what it is that is happening. This world, without argument, without discussion, you're not gonna beat the truth out of this. This world is a satanic ritual, period, dot, period. The vast majority of people are either worshiping Satan directly, which is what these magicians are doing. They have absolutely sold their souls, and they have absolutely allowed demons to possess them in order to become famous and to become rich. This is exactly what they have done, and this is exactly what you are seeing. You are seeing the demons that have taken over their minds and that are operating within the flesh to impress people, to make people think that these people, these magicians, are godlike. And they are far from godlike. They are demonic-like, because demons have possessed them and are performing before mass groups of people who are applauding them, and that applaud and that worship is being given directly to the God of this world, Satan. So the next time you applaud anything like this, just know you're not applauding God. You're not applauding the Lord and the Savior, Jesus Christ, who died on that cross for your sins and is being mocked by these people. You're applauding Satan, you're applauding demonic spirits, and you are applauding people who have sold their souls, mocking God, mocking Christ, or attempting to, because we know God can't be mocked. They're certainly going to find that out. But they are certainly attempting to mock God and mock Christ. And if you applaud this, if you find this amusing, if you find this entertaining and idolizing, I suggest that you turn away from this, repent of it. It is an absolute sin to applaud those that mock Jesus Christ. If this video has edified you or brought you to a new level, if you appreciate the videos, if you appreciate the messages, please sub the channel, click the like button. Actually, I've removed the like button. I'm not allowing that anymore. I want to test something. I'm putting YouTube through a test. So there'll be no more thumbs up or thumbs down. But there will be a bell that you can click for the updates. And as well, share these videos. Please mirror them on your channels. I've gotten a lot of people come to this channel because you guys have mirrored them, and I appreciate that, and I'm very thankful. I also ask that you guys look in the description for ways to help others. This is a desperate time, and the more we can help, the better it is for others. And for me, it's not about me. I could care less. I don't own a cell phone. I don't own gold. I don't own a watch. I don't own a car. I don't own a home. I don't own anything. I've given all that up. I gave it all back to the world. So what you're going to do is you're going to help others. You're going to feed the hungry. You're going to clothe children. You're going to give the ability for people to be able to sustain life without the pressure of struggle that these people over here in the Dominican go through every single day. I ask that you think about that. I ask you think about becoming a Patreon. PayPal me if you need to, if that's your best way. You can PayPal me. If you have cell phones you're not using, that's in the description. Feel free to email me. You can send cell phones. I'll set them up and give them to students that need them. I ask that you guys as well join Flat and Elected 2, the backup channel. And if you can, come on out. I know you can. What do you mean? If you can, join Flat Out Elected, the community on Google+. I notice a lot of you have, and I appreciate it. It's a good place to put videos, watch videos, share information, and meet others that are like-minded to us. I ask that God sincerely bless you guys. I'm going to do the next video is going to be on the music industry, and I'm going to show how it's no different than the magic industry. It's all entertainment. It's all meant to enter and sustain, hold your mind. I'm going to show you exactly what they're doing over there in the music industry in my next video. I ask that God bless you guys sincerely, deeply, and abundantly. You guys take care of yourselves.
Is when you talking to the principalities and reminding the powers and telling them who you are and what's going to happen. That's when you get an attitude. We have access to God with boldness and confidence. We can go boldly to the throne of God. We can go confidently to him. But what does the devil do? He keeps bringing up your past. He keeps bringing up your failures. He keeps bringing up your shortcomings. I'm not going to God on the basis of my righteousness. Not my righteousness. I'm going on the basis of his righteousness and who he is.